All right. So I know Jackie talked about her experiences with the Dominican Republic last week. I want to talk today about my experiences with our own mission trips and how I came to be involved in them. Epworth has been doing mission trips for years, a couple decades. I started in 2010. Before that, they visited places like Louisiana and West Virginia. My first trip with Mitch with Epworth was to the Bahamas in 2010, as I said. Up until that point, I had been a Christian for maybe 4 years. At that point, I was still learning what it was to be part of God's kingdom. And I didn't quite know where my place was just yet. But at that point in my life, I've been renovating my house on my own. And I've been learning how to do things, building things and fixing things and that kind of thing. And I picked up these skills and I felt like I needed to do something more than just working on my own house. And this was announced, the Bahamas trip, and I felt an urging, a push, I guess, a calling, I guess would be the word, to go on this trip. I was fortunate that I was able to do that. I had the vacation time to do it. We had a brand new baby sitting in the front row. And fortunately, Melissa was willing to stay home for a week with her and while I went on adventures. And I also, in sort of a, what do we call a God moment, the trip itself was $1,000 to go, and my employer paid for the whole thing at the time. Everything kind of lined up to allow me to do this, and I felt like this was God wanted me to start on a new part of what it meant to be, or part of being in His kingdom and being in ministry. Why I knew I wanted to do this, and I wasn't quite sure what to expect when we went on it. That first trip in Bahamas was certainly thought-provoking and maybe even life-changing because of the things that we encountered on there. One thing I want to show you was, this was part of the Bahamas trip, and a few people here were on that trip, so they'd be able to remember this. This is what's called All Saints Camp. It is essentially a dumping ground for people who are sick, primarily AIDS. They're brought there because their families either can't take care of them or won't take care of them through some stigma, or in some cases maybe even feeling they're cursed. So people are living in little shacks in that area. I ended up being a part of the group that was re-roofing houses. There were other people there who were fixing walls, repainting, and that kind of thing. And to meet the people that were there, and also the other people we met during the trip, is the kind of thing where you can't encounter that anywhere unless you actually go do it. Especially depending on where you live, you could even be insulated from that kind of stuff. And that's who, this was a gentleman who was living there, and we delivered lunch for him. He's very kind. He was very gracious for what we were doing there. But it's those are the kind of things where you don't necessarily know what you're going to be doing when you get there. Then you find that there are things that you can contribute to and go to. There was another trip later on in 2011 where we went to New Mexico. This is located at a shelter for women and mothers who are abused. This was in the Navajo Nation. There is a high degree of alcoholism there. This was a mission that was located next to a church that housed sheltered abused women. There was a request to do something with this field so that not only the women who were staying there would have would be able to contribute something, not only to them, but also the surrounding community. We don't know anything about irrigation and all that, but we decided we'd throw ourselves into it, had it shipped a generator there, and we tilled that field, not only with the tractor, but also by hand, and ended up creating an irrigation. There's a result. Creating basically new life in the desert, and not only that, but planted crops in there. Those are the kind of things we've done over the years. Since I've been part of the mission trip, we've also gone to Maine and Winthrop, Maine, Cherokee, North Carolina, Bergall, North Carolina, doing all things like this. Just digging in, doing things, anything that is necessary, working with the local groups. And there's one other thing that's also important. We don't go into a community thinking we know what's going on and what needs to be done. We partner with organizations that are local. These ideas that we did here were from the church where we were working at. Same thing with the Bahamas, same thing with Cherokee and Bergall and all that. And we also don't really discriminate about to anybody or anything, or anybody who wants to come. We have all, our age range has always been sixth grade and up. There's no upper limit. A lot of people in here know Florence, Florence McNeary. She went on many mission trips. She was always the oldest in the crew. In fact, we usually had three generations because we had Susan and Isaac on there as well. But Florence never was shy about digging in and helping with all that. And everything went down to sixth grade. The people we bring on the trip, especially the youth are not automatically assigned the menial task. Anybody who wants to learn something new and contribute is able to do that, including this was we had Andrea Vucciolo with and cut stuff and getting stuff done there. We also had our most recent trip, Sujay Vuchal and Noah Price up on a roof, and me included, in 90 degree near 100% humidity, re-roofing the building we were staying in. We were actually staying in this building. We were re-roofing it as we were staying in it that week. This was in the hope that they could use that building for future mission trips. Nobody is. There's nothing that anybody is not allowed to do. If you want to learn how to do it, you can do it. We don't, like I said before, there's no limit on who can come. Anybody can come on the trip if they feel moved to come on the trip. And you can do anything from the construction work all the way down to yard work, painting, cleaning floors, everything, anything there is. Because all of that is important to the people that we're going to serve. But that is, this is why it has always been a passion of mine, because of what we have been able to accomplish and what we do in serving God and what we do in the name of Jesus.
So. Anybody have any questions for Mike? He said we could ask him questions this morning. How many of you have been on a mission trip? Anybody here feel like sharing a little bit of your experience as well? This is a time to convince other hearts to join you in mission. Come on, shy people. Yes. Wow. Thank you, Sharon, for sharing that. Anybody else?
So let me add there, I didn't talk about that before, but that's a good point to bring up. Epworth is not just on mission trips. We have always done local work as well. We have been a part of Baltimore County Christian Work Camp for years. That has always been a good alternative for people who can't necessarily take off or want to go out of town, but it has a week of work that is done locally, same kind of thing. Epworth was known for building ramps, wheelchair ramps, for years. There is also yard work and, you know, other painting and that kind of thing that can be done, all in Baltimore County, Baltimore County's residents. Also, I'm wearing Goodwill Thanksgiving Dinner. This is something that was done every year by the Goodwill organization. They took off a couple years like everything else for because of COVID, but they did return this past Thanksgiving. They serve a Thanksgiving meal, a hot Thanksgiving meal for thousands of people who are around. And it's one day. So that is something where if you feel like your job does not give you the opportunity to be able to take off a week, you can do one day, the day before Thanksgiving. Work camp is, you can actually also do just 1 or 2 days at work camp as well. So those are opportunities for people who can't necessarily go out of town. Those are, you know, again, any kind of skill and age range. So.
Up in the choir, someone's got a hand up.
I just want to catch on to the local mission trips that I took. Bryant expressed his interest, and I thought, where did this come from? And it was because he, I think, became a part of the youth group and had seen other youth, and he's not a, you know, out there outgoing, gonna join any group, do anything. And when he expressed interest in doing the Baltimore County Work Camp, I took him, and really he spent way more time there than I did. He spent several days with Mike and the crew, and the growth and development in his character and in his skill set, I will always be thankful for it, because he now goes out and does Eagle projects as the guy who does the drilling and the sewing and the sawing and all this stuff with his hands that I would never have seen him do had he not had this opportunity. So I'll be forever grateful for the opportunity that these local mission trips have had.
Amen.
So that last year, in sort of an effort to get us back into the habit of going on mission trips, we did a local mission trip where we worked at First Fruits Farm up in Parkton, and we built a woodshed for them. Not an enclosed woodshed, but an overhang to keep it dry. Bryant was the only one who was there with me every day. And everybody else came and contributed, like Toby and all that. They contributed a day or two here as they could, which we were, you know, forever grateful for. I was grateful that Bryant was there, because there was actually one day where it was just us, and it would have been a little lonely if I had just been working there by myself. So I was grateful for Bryant's help, and he was a hard worker that day. So.
And I couldn't do physical work last year because of my physical condition right now. But I took lunch up to them, and they got to eat because we had people who did lunch every day. And I started my mission trip experience with Habitat for Humanity in Baltimore at Sandtown and Chesapeake. And if you can picture me standing on a porch roof with an axe, pulling this porch roof off between my legs, and I'm like, what am I going to stand on? And he said, just keep moving back, girl, just keep moving back. He had to cut through about 16 layers of tar paper and tar with the axe, and then use the crowbar and pry it up as you stood and backed up. I also learned how to put in insulation and itched for about 10 weeks after. But there's work for everybody to do, and don't think you're too old or too young or too feeble or too this or too that. Amen? Anybody else have a question for Mike or a comment about one of your mission experiences? John.
The mission trips skill level for everybody. And then the young people that come with us, they are, you can't imagine how they are. And we have kind of a tradition of trying to help those who maybe can't afford to go. So if you're called to go and want to come,
we'll get you there.
We'll find a way to get you there.
We'll get you there, amen. Amen. Thank you, John. Anybody else have something to say? Yes.
It was really hard for me to learn. No one was on a group in the middle school.
I was thinking, do we need to go out there and revive you when you saw the video evidence of your son on a roof?
But he was always really proud of himself for doing that. He was always really grateful, I think, that people had faith and abilities and taught them to do that. And then all the time he spent building ramps. And with his skills team at Delaney, he was he saw the value in building a ramp for accessibility so that kids could go outside for lunch, because there's a step outside to the outside food court for lunch. And so he and his skills group, mostly them, I think, were able to just build this small ramp so that everybody for accessibility could go outside.
Amen. It's amazing. Mike, where'd you see Christ on your trips?
You see Christ everywhere in there, in the people that you're serving, because it's a poverty level that you may not have encountered before, yet you still see joy in people. Not only the people you see, but also like the circumstances that bring it about. We certainly had, here, I didn't bring us up fourth. In the Bahamas, we were serving a gentleman who had been living in a house without water for 50 years. The church that he was serving, he was actually serving at a church as an usher, and the church we were staying at, the church decided to provide him with water in his house, running water in his house, and we were running the pipes into the house. Now, we were not tasked with connecting the pipes to anything. Nobody had been picked, nothing had been set up to bury the pipes to the water line that was out in the road. Somebody on our crew saw this gentleman with a backhoe driving down the road and flagged him down, asked him if he could dig a hole. So he did. And so that's him doing it right now, right in that picture. It's kind of amazing, you know, you can't be shy about things. You can sort of just, you know, do something, just ask about it, and sometimes God will deliver in that. And you find those other things in there, right? I mean, you can call them coincidence, maybe they aren't. But, you know, also you can see that God is with you during that trip, so.
Amen. Well, I did ask Mike to include another little video in there.
I just wanted to ask,
okay,
what are some of the mission trips and other things in here and abroad that you're doing this year?
Well, so, okay, it's a good thing to bring it up. So we were going to do a mission trip at the end of June. We actually announced it back in the fall, if anybody was here during that service. But we got started on it rather late. So we're not having a trip this year at the end of June, like being attended, but we are definitely going to do one next year, end of June. If you want to put that on your calendar. We're going to start working on it now, so we make sure we get everything in place. We get the fundraising set up. That's one thing that's always a lot of work, is to get that fundraising in place, set up events and that kind of thing. But end of June, we haven't decided exactly where we're going yet. We could go to Kentucky. It's a new place that we haven't been to before, but Jackie, our children's coordinator, has been to before, suggested it. We may go back to Maine. Like with anything anything nowadays, the mission at Camp Mashawana in Maine, which is where we've gone before, is hurting for volunteers. So I know we'd be more than welcome to go back there. Or there may be some other place that maybe God is telling us to go to. We don't know yet. A few people, including me, are possibly thinking about going to Dominican Republic in January to go on that trip, to on that mission, the Least of These Ministries, that was
called? Least of These.
Least of These Ministries.
The feeding ministry.
To serve there in Dominican Republic. So that's an opportunity as well.
Baltimore County Christian Work Camp is coming up. Their 40th anniversary this year.
Baltimore County Christian Work Camp happens every year. Epworth has always been a part of it. Last year we did not have a person leading it. I was not able to lead it because of other circumstances that got in the way of it. But if Epworth wants to put together a site of its own to work at, somebody would need to lead that. If there isn't a leader, you can still contribute to it. John and Gail did work it last year. And you can still contribute to that. You can actually go and just join another team. You can go to a site, do anything. So that's a possibility. Answer your question?
Yes.
Okay. Terry did want me to play this video, which is an example of a very young person perhaps learning what it means to be on a mission trip. This is Megan at 2.5 years old. She wanted to help me put a camera together.
You did it. Go ahead, Nanette. We're going to do the next one. Come here. That's good. That's enough. Yeah. Thank you, Megan.
That's determination there, baby.
Still getting the hang of the girl.
She needs some help.
Oh.
Here, try it that way. You gotta push it in, Megan. All right. That's another good one, Megan.
Okay. Anyway, that's the kind of thing that's where. I would have Sarah and Megan help me around the house, and then I'd post something like that on Facebook, and somebody would say, you got a good crew there, and if it was somebody from church, I would always respond with, well, I'm building my own mission team. And that's sort of playing on what Toby has said, and what Sarah has said. Part of the reason you take youth on there is to inspire them and to teach them so that can pass that on to them. You can do all the work, but then you need somebody behind you coming in who's going to replace you at some point. So that's another part, a huge part of trips like that.
Amen. That's how faith is transmitted too. It's not just skills, it's the faith. It's the reason behind the work. And we can do that with our children, we can do that with each other, we can encourage one another. So if you want to make a commitment to be part of the mission team this year, either for Baltimore County Christian Work Camp, we're looking for a leader for that team. We're looking for, we want to put our own team together this year, or John and Gail last year just took part in another team, and their number of teams greatly diminished because of COVID. We're trying to build things back after COVID, like our youth program. COVID killed our youth program because we could not meet together. We want to get that back up and rolling. We want to get our mission teams out fully functioning in the world again, because the world needs us greatly. They need our faith, and they need our hard work and our labor. Now, if you can't do anything else, you could write a check. We'll take your check. Duh, said the pastor. Now, if you feel like you cannot go physically, but you have $1,000 to send somebody to the Dominican Republic, do that. I may do that myself. I'm going to give something. I'm not sure how much it'll be, but it'll be significant. It means I have to skip some stuff in my own life. I'll skip some stuff in my own life to make room for somebody else in my life who needs help. And our kids are wonderful here. And look at our acolytes. We have 8 acolytes who are spectacular servants of Jesus Christ. We have our processional cross. I just asked Mr. Jeremiah if he'd like to carry it again on Pentecost. And he said, yeah, he'll carry that cross. But we all have a cross to carry into the world. So I hope you will all take the time and the effort that it takes to get involved in the mission of the church, because that's where you will find yourself and you find your heart. You'll find Christ there. Amen, amen, amen. You have anything else, Mike?
No, that's it.
That was great. Thank you. Thanks.